Are you jealous inside the Kaunas Arena here in Kaunas, Lithuania? Just had the national anthems of the first quarterfinal. Here is the schedule of the quarterfinal day at the FIBA Under 17 World Championships. USA, Canada, Australia, Argentina, and then finally Croatia, Czech Republic. Follow on from the first quarterfinal between Spain and China. Second place team in Group B with a 3-2 record, enjoyed wins over Korea, Lithuania and Canada to reach this quarterfinal. China, third place team in Group A with wins over Egypt, France and the Czech Republic, also enjoyed a 3-2 record. Here are the stats of this tournament so far. Deck from Argentina has had a marvellous composition, nearly 20 points per game. Lezonja from Croatia with 19.4. The home favourite says Kaus from Lithuania has 17.2 points. Neither of these teams have anyone in the top 5 scorers. In terms of their iron feet, team nature of both teams. The off go from Spain, 10 rebounds a game, he enjoys a double-double on the tournament so far. And Yu from China with over 9 rebounds per game. The off go, the Senegalese-born Spanish big man, is coming up a 29.4 against Croatia in the last game. Lithuania hosted a tremendous tournament so far. As we get a look at the assist leaders, Sam Vals from Spain dips into the fifth position with over 4 assists a game. But this Kaunas Arena at times has been packed, obviously, when the hosts have been on display. But having hosted last year's Eurobasket, FIBA Under 17 World Championships has been a tremendous success here in Lithuania. Number 6 there for China. Wu Jiangsu in China has invited the Chinese coaching staff who did perform so far in this competition. Here's the team roster for Spain and Jaume Diop, 2m8 centre with the Masonica club in Spain, has left the lineup with 14 points, 10 rebounds. Ably supported by number 7 there, Augustin Sanz. 12 points. Here's Alangelo Martinez, the head coach of Spain. And here's the Chinese roster with number 13, Liu Qiu. Leaving them with 11 points a game so far, and coach Wang has been impressed with the way this team has adjusted to the different styles of basketball in this competition. Jayun Jun Wang, head coach, 2 games away from what he will hope will be a final. This Under 17 World Championships. The defending champions from 2 years ago in Germany, the USA, will follow this game with a semi-final clash against North American rivals Canada. But highlighting the 2 leading scorers of the tournament so far for both countries, Yon and Yu. Almost getting that magical double-double stat, 10 points over and double-digit points whereas Diop has that 14.10 rebounds per game. And as we just highlighted, came off an immense performance against Croatia. 29 points. Big day for these youngsters here, the three officials. Oh, there's Mr. Vasquez from Paraguay with his team of officials from Lithuania and Ukraine. Starting 5-4 Spain with Tartan at the point, and a really good tournament so far. Camilla and Royce on the wings with Torres and Diop on the inside. Starting lineup alongside Hugh. Joao at the point, Kane and Hahn on the wings, and Beaulieu, number 15, on the inside. Can China keep Spain off the boards? Spain doubling the number of Chinese offensive rebounds. Backdoor cut. Great move off the first play. And two quick points for China. Take it right to the heart of the Spanish defense. And Joao gets the first 2 points. But a quickness underneath as the Chinese defense tries to switch. Spain. We don't get a great look. The whistle's already gone as the baseline's being set. Diop with a three out of bounds. Not really what you could put down in the scouting report. Great steal and foul. And Alberto Martin from Real Madrid picks up a steal and a foul first. Opportunity again. Sal discharges the first foul. Martin will go to the free throw line. Spain struggling a little as a team from the free throw line, only shooting 62% on the tournament so far. Achilles heel of this Spanish lineup has gone unnoticed by the coaching staff from China. 0-2, a defensive rebound. As well. China in the half court. They spread the floor really well. They shoot the three three-point shot far better than Spain in this tournament so far. Pick and roll. To the inside, nice handoff. Diop challenges the shot, but wow, nice feed. Gets these first 2 points. 4-0 China. Tough shot off the glass. Diop's all over the boards as he's been all tournament. This is the short shot and the ball saved. And China will have possession. And Heng gives it back to Zhao. And Zhao as he pushes. And again, he's looking to break down the defense. Four and top into the true high post. Turn down the high post shot. Zhao gets it back. Long two. Just off. Diop comes down with another rebound. Spain have a chance to run in transition. Great penetration to the hoop, and the two is good by Moyes. And Spain tipped the scoreboard over for the first time. 8 minutes to go, first quarter. Both teams look comfortable. They make the intensity and the torque to the game. Nice pass again on the inside, nice combination, but couldn't handle the ball. Just recovered, a little unlucky for Spain. They cannot get the steal, but Diop gets the defensive rebound, and they've got a foul on Beaulieu. And very early in the game, 7:30, 9 seconds to go in the first quarter. China have picked up their third team foul. Alberto Marte calling things for. And Diop goes to the middle, nice lead. Another miss, good defense that time by the length of Woo. Foul in transition as Jose Nogales will be charged with the foul. First team foul for Spain. Good push and transition by China on that occasion. Draws the contact, finds himself at the free throw line, and 70% free throw shooter on the tournament so far. Makes the first. Positive start by the Chinese national team here. Would have come into this game slight underdogs. Their first appearance of the under-17 World Championship. 6-2 start, China have it. 7 minutes to go in the first. Diop again. Real emphasis on the Spanish offense early here. Diop going to work inside. Short jump hook is good. See where those double digits per game come from. 1 from 4, he's already had 4 shots. His percentages are far better than that on the tournament so far. Three inside again. Here he goes back outside. We've got a traveling ball. Spain with a good closeout. Romila. Good closeout. Takes away the penetration. Causes the travel. Love the official. Martin penetrates. Turnover. And Diop going to get called for the foul. Had the two, but tried to pass it up. Strong by hand, and he has to back it out. China showing great patience early on. Penetration wide open, long two is off. Rojao and Diop just keep rebounding the basketball. Runs the floor so well, wants it on the inside, doesn't get it. What an athlete is Diop. Mustang penetrates, Diop has it. About back in, tries to go to work, gets to the middle, goes up the jump hook, is short, and Drew, a decent defensive stance again. Yao has it. Really do like the tempo that the Chinese have set here. Three's gone early, and sweet from deep. Long arm with the three-pointer. China are the team that have the real momentum here early. Same set, both teams getting two low posts. Good defense again by China. Very, very quick. Diop has it in the post again. Diop going to work to the middle, going up. This time left hand, jump hook is good. And Diop has 4 of the 6 points. Again up the floor with the defense. Balls to turnover and have another opportunity. So this time, tired. Not a good one. The shot was there. Romero so focused on getting the ball to Diop, passes up the open shot. And Spain gets it straight back to China. Full court pressure, looking to wear him down, breaks to the middle. Nice pass again, knocked away. And again, the problem is there for you all to see. Diao breaking down the Spanish defense far too easily. Boys, he's charging the power. These rolls should have really gone up after great penetration by Diao. Ball knocked out of bounds, 4:49 to go, quarter one in China. But at the moment, they're getting the shots they want. Inside again, nice move to the baseline. In traffic, can't take the contact and score, but really quick first step by PGR. touch Spain. And too high post with Diop slicing to the basket. Double team comes. Needs to pass. Gets the pass off. Martinez. Nowhere to go. Deep on the shot clock. Diop gets it down low for the dunk. Great patience by Spain. But everything going through Diop at the moment. 6 for the first 8 points. And this hand just shoots straight at home and not help. Great hands by Martin. Martin has a chance to push in transition. Gets to the keyway. Now he needs to pass. Gets it back. Pulls the half court set. Martin comes off the off. Skip pass. 3 point is way off. Defensive rebound by Zial. Nice look by Steiner on the break in transition. We've got a foul as Zial gave up the pass. WA Wolves. Gets charged with a foul. Great shot by China on the break. Ball released on the floor. And he's being really critical of Yilong Han. He should have really scored. China, who shoot the free throws so much better than Spain. In close games with fouls mounting up, you know that's going to be a factor. De Long Han makes the first. And he goes 2 for 2 from the line. And China re-established that 3-point lead in a relatively low-scoring game. China has a 2-point lead, 3.5 to go in the first quarter. Diop gets another touch. Faces, goes baseline, help comes, needs to pass, wraps it around. Great rotation by China. They showed the baseline, double team. Diop went back to the middle. They rotated out of that and they come up with a steal. And Spain, because of criticism so far, a little bit predictable about where the offense is going. And China have obviously spent a lot of time in the gap between the end of the group and the quarterfinals, scouting that and preparing very, very well. Yeah. Into that Horns offense. Wu looks about, thinks about, doesn't take the three though. Thinks again. In fact, as Yao goes to the hoop again, misses the layup. And if China could have finished in transition, they would have had a much bigger lead than three. Martin to the basket is fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. Got to pick himself up off the floor. Felt that one. Diop trying to pick him up. Nice penetration. Bo Liu picks up foul number 2. After picking up 3 team fouls in the first 2.5 minutes, that's the first foul by China in the next 4 or 5 minutes, so they've managed to control the foul situation. Alberto Martin. Obviously a lot to live up to for this under 17 Spanish national team. Success in the last few years in European Championships, obviously the men's program. And I tell you, 2006 World Champions team in Edmonton. The Olympics in LA. Last year on this court, they became the Eurobasket champions. Got traveled on the inside by Finn Ma. Martin pulls the trigger for 3, that's off. Demar gets a positive stat for defensive rebound. Yao pushes. And DeLong Hong pulls it out. Back to the inside again. Almost a turnover saved by Yao. Great job by him. Hong comes off the high post screen. Demar puts it on the floor, going to work to the middle. Misses a little two-footer. And Spain come down with a time push. Martin in transition gets to the foul line. well, he was always going to pass. And that's how the defense played the penetration. So fouled on the pass. Spain has to have a turnover off the feet of the Chinese defense. So Spain get it back. Diop wants it, gets it on the inside. Mars giving him a hard time. Diop, lots of dribble, gets to the middle. Great help, turnaround, tough jump shot is off. That's a great work on the glass, and I think we're going to get the ball for Spain. That's an excellent job on the inside defensively. Beaulieu and came across, he did a tremendous job on the help. China having highlight dish they may have had on the defensive boards with the great offensive numbers that Spain had on the glass. As a team, they did a tremendous job on the defensive end. 11-10, a minute 30 to go in the first quarter. Diao gets rid of it to Yilong Han. Puts it on the floor, gets to the middle, needs one. Diao, feet set for three, count those. Wei Xiao comes down with three, 14-10 with a minute to go in the first quarter. Trademark Chinese basketball, penetration and the kick, excellent execution. 2-2 from beyond the arc. Diop, they go lob, help comes quickly, has to go back to the middle. Great rotation and scramble. Oka three hits nothing, and the Spanish Rose from beyond the three-point line continue. They shoot only 22% on the tournament. Gets things moving to Jin Nao. Diao gets it back, foul line, thinks about the jump shot, gives it to Ma. He pulls up for a long two, that's off. Chance for Spain in transition to. Gets something early, but they throw it back out. Abelada puts it on the floor, and then he gives it up. Guez went to the basket. He's fouled. He'll find himself on the free throw line in the last 30. Half a minute of the first quarter. Beaulieu goes out with three fouls. Beaulieu, 2-1 center. And they are in China. It's down. That's the issue the Chinese have. They really are a little out athletic on the inside. Physicality is going to be a problem. And fouls could become big factor as this game develops. Jose Noguez makes the second, so 1-2. China still maintaining that 3-point lead. They've had it most of the game. Substitutions are plenty from the Spanish bench. 57 is not a number that Spain are going to enjoy looking at when they review those first quarter stats. Diao has it. Dinmar gives it up. The long two is off. Defensive rebound is pulled in by Alvarado. He's pushing. Ball control again by Spain. They're going to try and grind this one out. There's the high post screen. Alvarado for three is off. Defensive rebound by Dinmar. And China can't get or almost get the prayer, but at the end of the first quarter, China established an early lead and have maintained that throughout. They lead 14-11 over Spain, and Spain really are struggling to get anything going offensively. Shooting two from eight, 25% on the quarter. We're going to get those stats confirmed. In fact, Spain on the quarter, literally shooting 4 from 14. Only 50% from the free throw line as well. And of those 14 shots until he sat down with 30 seconds to go. Diop, Diman, Dimop, Diop has taken 8 of those shots. So whereas the Chinese offense is spread, no one taking more than 4 of the 12 shots they took in that first quarter. It's a clear strategy here that Spain are going to throw the ball inside the op as often as they possibly can. Well, there's confirmation of those statistics. 4 from 9 and 0 from 5, so 4 from 14. It does not make great reading. Chinese turnovers are a bit of a factor there. 5 turnovers have enabled Spain to really hang around. No offensive rebounds for China. They have not really been productive in that aspect of the game at all in this competition. Spain have possession of the basketball. Start of quarter two. First semi-final of the FIBA Under 17. World Championships here in Lithuania, one of the spiritual homes of basketballers. Not the prettiest start as David Alate from Maloka, the Huven 2 center, shows his ball-handling prowess, or lack of it, unfortunately for him. Just indecisive, came off his right foot. And China gets the chance to increase that 3-point lead straight away. Whoa, turns it over, so turnovers continue to be an issue. Nice penetration as Alberto Alvarado goes to the basket, picks up the first 2 points for him, and Spain trail one. Thiao continues at the point. Going to play a lot of minutes for China with Zhao Weijiao. And we have a foul called off the ball. Marcus Portale. Forward, finds himself a little bit outside in the post against Keith Yu. And Yu giving all sorts of problems here. Jiao looks inside. He can't get it. Jiao, nice penetration. Great work on the boards and two offensive rebounds back to back and the putback. Yu with two and Yu with 4 points. He's maybe shooting 2 from 5, but he's really putting a shift on the inside for China. And the offensive foul is called. Andre Angelova picks up a stat you don't want as your first stat, a foul. China again with controlled tempo, but they're always looking to be aggressive. Yu settles for the long jump shot, he's good. Yu averaging 11 a game so far in the tournament, starts to tick over the scoreboard to China. 18-13 and they're getting shots they want. Spain have got an issue here. Foul line jump shot is no good. Defensive rebound pulled in by Han. And China a chance to run. Great aggressive move, but we're going to get a travel call. Good defensive stance by Alberto Alvarado. Alvarado, excellent stance, didn't take the fake. Angelova gets the high post screen. Diop back in the game, dives to the bucket, gets it at the front of the ring. Double team comes, but went for the steal and didn't take away the trap, the space. Poor play by Diao, went for the steal, should have really come and helped and stood his ground and taken away the opportunity for Diop to go to work close to the hoop. Wide open, Diao pulls the trigger for three. It's off, defensive rebound, Spain, chance to run. And Grover pushes, but gets to the middle, nice push, nice positive penetration. Draws the contact on Diao and Spain. Need to get more of a rhythm here early in the second quarter. Two fouls on Jowie. That's not a good number for China. Good penetration. Defense was never set on Drew Ondrova, a Drover from the Balearic Islands. Spain struggling. They've struggled all tournament from the free throw line. They continue to do so. Ondrova goes 1-for-2 on the back of a friendly roll from the ring. And China have a 16 lead, 7.5 to go in the first half. Beginning to wear down this Chinese offense at the moment, Spain. Every pass the last couple of minutes has been a great first step. Tough step back is good, and that was sweet. Hans really showing some potential on that move. Really quick first step, step back, short two. Nice penetration and move by the young. Number 10 for China there. From Jilin in China. Oh, nice move to the hoop by that Drover. Drover with the 3 points personal, but that was a sweet move in traffic. Diane Zhu. He's going to have to put a decent amount of time in here as Diao has the foul trouble. Spinning move, Diop challenges it. He forces the missed shot. And Drover pushes it. Diop's down the floor. They step off. Now he gets it. Where's the double team going to come from? Going to work. They play a one-on-one this time, and I think they're going to get a travel. That's a change by the Chinese. Went one-on-one with Yop that time. Oh, outside from the three-point line. Trying to clear away some traffic, though. Two-on-two game. Now they reverse the ball. To the middle, but a pass is coming and he almost bumped into his own player, this Joe. Wide open for three, is away and hasn't hit anything again. Don't think I've seen a Spanish team shoot the perimeter shot as inconsistently as this one is doing at the moment. Well, it's very consistent, it's four, but Peng outside, finds hand. Strokes it for three, put that one in the book, 23-18, and Dylan Hound becoming a real factor in the game. 5.5 to go in the second quarter. Oh, just about recovered by Gordy. Riley going to the basket, off the glass, kisses it, doesn't get to two, gets his own rebound though. Dribbles attack out, Spain get into the half court. A Drover. Puts it on the floor. Diop gives him the screen and then seals low. Gets it on the foul line. Jump shot's gone and long. Defensive rebound. Zhuo pulls it in and China again looking to build on the 5-point lead. Zhuo going to the inside. Nice move. Oh, what a block. Great athleticism. A great effort by the youngster. Zhuo stays with the play after the block. Picks up his 8 points. Let's have a look. There's the first one. Gets blocked. Doesn't get disappointed. Goes up strong the other way. And a soft touch gives him the 2 points. Spain takes the timeout. Mahanes has 10 points. He really has a good second quarter. Hu getting very close to already to a double-double. 7 points to go with the 8-point chip. Over four to go in the half. And it's their tempo has taken with their tempo, their high percentage shots. They've done an excellent job, and that number tells you how well they're doing at sharing the basketball and getting the ball to where they want. 5 assists to 1 for Spain. And Spain may be a little predictable here in really overemphasizing Diop, but so they've struggled to shoot the ball from the perimeter. Slowly. Diop, deep, doesn't get it. The Chinese defense, the quickness, is really giving Spain a problem here. Grover tries to fire one off the glass. They didn't hit the ring. Diop's got to go up. Does he know? 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Turns around, hits the ring, but China gets a defensive rebound. They have a chance to get a double-digit lead here. A three-pointer will put them up 10 in a relatively low-scoring game, so things looking good for China. Yo. Double team now from Spain. Yo goes baseline in traffic. Gets the two. Tough move. He's yo. 10 points. Look at this. In traffic. 1-on-3. Takes the contact and gets the finish. Tough play. 9-point lead. Oh, nice crossover. Drover goes up. Kisses off the glass. Yop with a tip. And better, but it's still a little. There's no ball movement by Spain, relying on individual breakdown. And so far, the defensive effort by China has had all the answers.
Substitution, China Taiwan number 4, Chang Jiwei.
Alberto Martin rejoins the game. China takes the gamble with Yao. Trying to really hammer home the advantage they had. He's feeling it. Knocks down the long two. 12 points personal. Largely responsible for that 9-point lead. Diop wants it. Gets it in the low block. It's only 1-on-1 at the moment. Helps. Looks to come. Is off and the woes from the perimeter of Spain continue. 29-20. China pushing in transition. Great decision making by this Chinese team. Jiwon Han has it now. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Leads away. Off. Diop going to haul in another rebound. 2.5 to go in the first half. Martin calls the play. Spain getting a little help there from the bench. Chinese bench three. Oh, they haven't had a lot of minutes. Diop knocked away by Diao. Momentum's a huge thing basketball wise, but this age, it's a huge factor. The experience of being able to stop runs, etc., is not necessarily there. And the stat you just saw sums up half the problem that Spain has, with Diop at half their points. Make that more than half of the offensive rebound and the strong finish. To 22, China. Now it's faced with 2-3 zone by Spain. Spain's giving a different look defensively. Nice pass. The high post. The obvious two is Yai Feng Heng. Nice penetration baseline. Need to pass. Nice little finish. Tough move by Jose Gomez. Spain get it back to 5 on the back of those two, and China take the timeout with 1:49 to go here in the first half.
Well,
I'll show you a little free place here. They've been a great performance by China as a team. You know, the percentage is good. They've got great contribution. Yo on the inside, and Jiwon Han has really showed some quality. Averaging 9 points, maybe 10 points coming into the game. Soft touch on that release. So, 9 for next week. Yacht having 12 at their point. Maybe over-focused on getting in the ball too much. China obviously prepared how they're going to deal with that. 20 of the Spanish points from the inside. He's yet to make a perimeter jump shot. 150. At the half remaining, China with a 5-point lead. Spain staying in the two-three zone. Matching up really aggressively. Penetration wide open in the corner is short. And Dulles gets the rebound. 1-on-3. Good job by the Hinden 2 forward. Possession arrow will favour China. China with a new shot clock. Oh, an offensive foul. He's going to get charged to the end of the first half. He's yelled.
Joe C, the first personal foul.
Back it in, throws up the hook, that'll be on the way down. And going away to Diop is really starting to help. China keying their defense up so much on the big Diop on the inside that other teams have now got the opportunity to play one-on-one and get good shots. So Spain, the zone and the combination of moving the basketball a little better, closes just to 3. Gio gets it on the inside here. Double team, now he needs to pass. And the change up defensively has really helped Spain. Miller will bring the ball in. Going over by Spain, going the other way though. Great penetration and kick. Wide open, 3 years off. And a man on the top, Gio gets another 2. Struggling on the offensive ball, Gio single-handedly is bringing up that stat for the Chinese. Gio outside the foul line. Faces, Gio just gaps him, gives him the shot. Martin penetrates, gets to the keyway. Penetrates, tough shot, no good. And again, Gio making change the shot, last 9 seconds. China trying to get it away. Share it beautifully. They've got to get the shot away though. 3 seconds. Pull up. But they got a good shot deep on the clock. And at the end of the first half, the Chinese and under 17 national team have a 31-26 lead over Spain. And it's been an excellent team performance by the Chinese. Spain have a little bit of momentum going into the half. Change up of defense and the move to take the ball away from Miliman Diop. There's confirmation. At half time, China lead 31-26. Spain, I'm sure they're going to start to make some jump shots. They absolutely have to. They are absolutely empty from the perimeter at the moment. China have had great performances by Milong Han and Kui Xiu. They've found a way to cope with Spain on the inside. So this one is set up to be tight all the way through. As both teams look for a semi-final berth. 2012 FIBA Under 17 World Championships here in Kaunas in Lithuania. A country that prides itself on developing young players will be loving the demonstration of these guys. Putting out on the floor. We're going to take around a 10-minute break. We'll be back in the second half. From Kaunas, we'll see you then. 10 rebounds. We've only reached half time. He has a double-double. 14 out of the 31 points that China put on the scoreboard in that first half. Before the game, all the hype, if that's the right word, was Illimani Diop. Diop from Spain. That was the talk. Would China be able to cope with him on the inside? Well, the answer to that is they've found a way to deal with him. He's picked up his points, that young man in the picture, but he's not shot a great percentage. Double team action from the Chinese defense has caused Spain some problems, and that's been compounded by the fact that Spain has just been unable to hit a shot from the perimeter. One shot from just on the edge of the keyway. Everything else has been on the inside or from the free throw line. China, on the other hand, have had some balanced scoring. Three three-pointers and some mid-range jump shots. And with Xiao, they've done an excellent job around the hoop. So here we go, the first quarterfinal of the 2012 FIBA Under-17 World Championships underway. And China looking to get that first semi-final spot. Can Spain come back? And there's goes up. Rushed shot, but gets his own rebound. Finds the off. Foul line jump shot is gone and he's off. And with a new 24, I'm not sure if that's his game. Diao in transition. Yu, double team, steps through, has it knocked away, but Diao saves it. The three's gone and it's long. King didn't knock the three down, but the start was much more positive from China than it was Spain. Okay, puts it on the floor, gets to the middle again, shoots, got blocked. Yeah, doing it at both ends of the floor. Scoring, rebounding, blocking. Yeah, steps back, thinks about the three, turns it down. Turnover by China on the penetration. And 11 Chinese turnovers. Will they come through Greco's? Yop tries to open up the middle, but they're not going to guard him on the perimeter. Martin penetrates, stops and pops, it's off. Diao gets the defensive rebound for China. Ken outside the two-point line looking to turn the corner. Diao gets it on the inside. Nice baseline penetration. Right bounce pass. Oh, and one. Bo Liu gets the drop. But it was all about Diao's smart pass. Second foul. Gets the traffic. And then just puts the bounce pass into space and tells Bo Liu, go get that. And Liu completes the three-point play. 8-point Chinese lead, 8 minutes to go in the third quarter. It's two high posts. Again, Martin creates traffic. Kicks to the hoop. Floating layup is no good and he's rebounded hard. And Moyes couldn't get the drop. Couldn't get the drop there, and great effort by Bo Liu. Well, this is where all the questions are being asked. China are asking questions of Spain. Have they got the answers? Yao gets the quick release for three and knocks it down, and we've got an 11-point game. Yao gave it up at the point, came off the screens, knocked down the three, and China have, if any team has momentum, they're the team with it at the moment. Diop going to work in the block, tries to step through. Oh, what a great athlete. Beautiful footwork on the move. He's up to 50% now. Had to work hard for that. Spain back to the 2-3 zone. Dangerous tactic with Diao on the floor. And we've got a 3-second call on Steve's view.
Substitution is Spain to the ball number 6.
Gomia comes out and Baldi comes in the game. Baseline pass to Diop in the post here. 1-6, so he goes baseline, nowhere to go. Somehow gets an angle and finishes, and he's so long, so athletic. Even with very, very good Chinese rotation, he found an angle off the glass, finished it well. China can't be passive, can't just pass the ball around him, outside of the zone. Diao penetrates, finds the open man, is off the three. Defensively, Nogoris gets it, pushes, good push. Picked up, in traffic, and there's the two. For Moez. They'd have answered that little run by China with one of their own. Spain. They've gone 6-0 there. I think they're going to travel. No, whistle called for a hold off the ball. Alberto Abolzi picks up. Foul. Number 6. We get it in. I have to go long on the inbound pass. Good quick entry pass here. Double team comes down on Diao. He's gone, he's off. Yeah, he just couldn't get it to drop. Martin has it. Wants his horns offense again. Those two high posts in. One of them will dive, and that's normally the op. The guys for the long two is short. Defensive rebound. Chance for China to run. They're quick in transition. Oh, Diao, the spin move. Gets to the middle. Kicks it. Yang. On the outside. Turnover. Spain, 2-on-1 break. Martin goes up and gets the two. And China are forced to take the timeout. They led by 11. And an 8-0 run by Spain. Gets them right back in it. And turnovers for China becoming a real issue. Chinese turnovers. They really do need the timeout. Maybe a little bit carried away with the emotion of the 3 points in the case of the 11 point lead. Since that three, haven't scored. And Spain scored in a hurry. There's the team leaders for China and Xu. 14 points, 11 rebounds, and one. Got blocks that aren't shown on that stat line. Two and a half minutes without a basket for China. And in that 2.5 minutes, Spain have run in 8. So, as we said earlier in the game, momentum huge. So a 6-0 start for the half by China, followed by an 8-0 riposte by Spain. Yuan Han inbounds to basketball. And China just needs to run some half court here. They need to look to see if they can get inside against this zone. Plymouth to face at the moment. Got inside now, Zhu has it. Inside, outside to China, Schild on the three. Zhu's on his own on the rebound. Noguez has it, pushes it, gets to the foul line, kicks. The early shot away, and it makes the first deep shot for Spain. And then ties it up. 11-0 run by Spain. The timeout for China hasn't stopped the run. The first three-pointer for Spain in the game. 4:30 to go, quarter three. The zone is just draining the life out of this Chinese offense. In the key way, Diop blocks it. We have a 24-second violation. The bleeding continues. Diop in the middle is just there. He's going to challenge every shot. Spain take the lead for the first time in a long time. Oh, Diop on the inside. Oh, great job. Milani goes up. Diop can't make the two, gets frustrated, but Alberto Abaldi. Abaldi comes up with the offensive rebound, draws the foul on the way up to the basket, finds himself on the free throw line with a chance to put Spain into the lead. Goes 1-2 and Spain have their first lead of the game. Early in the first half, Spain. In fact, it is their first lead of the game. Foul line jump shot, doesn't get the answer. Diop gets the rebound, we've got a foul on the rebound. And Beaulieu picks up the foul. That'll be his fourth foul. He's going to have to sit. Spain a chance now to build on the lead. China has got to show the belief in what they've been doing now. To the inside. Progress, good to see up, high post, see up. Puts it on the floor, spins to the middle, falls. Indecisive is the worst thing about that. Chance for China to run in transition, ball movement is good. Right, open for three is off. Chance here for Spain to look long, they do. Noguez gets it, goes up. There's one top to score, but foul's called. Yang is charged with the foul. Spain have to hammer home the advantage at the moment. Momentum wise, it's all about Spain. Oh, he thinks about the three, turns it down. Martin, quick turn of the corners, yells over to block it. Yet another positive stat for the big man on the inside for China. Nice little handle, finds open in the corner, he's off the three. There's a lid on that basket at the moment. Great transition by Spain, but they turn it over. Replay of that block. Wow. Tremendous job. Well, China has stopped Spain scoring, but this 2-3 zone is absolutely strangling China's offensive output. Another turnover for China. Substitution China. Well, we thought this would be a close one. Both teams with the same win-loss record coming into the game. China have done a better job on the offensive boards than anticipated. Diop's had a good game, but 15 Chinese turnovers are absolutely have kept Spain in this. now they've got a chance to lead by three. Ovaldi finds Diop, wants to hand it off, turns that down. Martin's got it, 4 seconds. Martin's got to fire it up. Stars in traffic, gets the glass, kisses it in. And whereas in the first half nothing was dropping for Spain, they're all starting to drop for Spain. 40-37, 2 minutes to go. And they're going to stay in the zone until China find a way to work it out. Oh, great pass, but Leo couldn't get the drop. And they haven't scored for nearly 8 minutes now. Collins penetrates, turnover, going nowhere. This should pick the scoreboard over. Diao misses the layup, little bump, gets away with it. And Martin says, hang on, let's run some half-court offense here. Diop's going to roll here, they're going to replace on the inside. Offensive foul, that's great defense again by Diao.
The second personal foul. Substitution.
Jamal Diop picks up foul two. Let's have a look. He's holding. That's crazy. That's right in front of the lead official. China desperately trying to pick the scoreboard over. Drought doesn't do this justice. Nice pass. To the inside for two for Heng. Off a nice pass by Yo. Yafeng Heng kicks it over for China. Spain struggling on this offense. Over. Step back, long two if that goes. Great job on the board. Boys comes down with the offensive rebound. Last 30 seconds of the third quarter. Grover looks inside. Goes. Little pick and roll action. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Deep, deep. Three is in the book. Oh, Goldie for three again. Well, he's got the swagger. Now he's backing it up with a point. Substitution for Spain in the last 13 seconds. If China could get a score here, it really helped the calls, because they really have 2 points in the last 8 minutes of this quarter. Foul calls. 6.5 seconds to go. And Blue and Glover Glover picks up the foul. They had one to give. Yo goes up, gets the drop, beautiful leading hook. I don't think the clock started, that's what the issue is. Look at this move, leans in, knows exactly what he wants to do, floats it with the right hand. Seconds now on the game clock. Spain, who after trailing in this quarter early, outscored China in the last 7 minutes, 11-2, 13-2. Got to get it away. It's too late.
After the
11-2 run, Spain right back in this lead, 43-41. China have to find an answer to that Spain zone, or they will have no way of making the semi-final of the FIBA Under 17 World Championships. 2-3 zone by Spain has just stifled Chinese offense. That three put them up 11. They go in two down. a combination of better perimeter shooting by Spain and the 2-3 zone meant Spain now have the momentum. They are in the ascendancy. They are confirming the favourite status that they had coming into the game. Will really believe they have a chance. Great sign for Spain as their numbers are going up every quarter. If they go up again, it's going to take a hell of an effort for China to stifle the Spanish team. It's Loba. Smart play to keep it alive. Now he's in space, gets to the foul line, kicks it. Aldi is off the three. Work on the glass by Spain, they have bodies there. Morris and Loba. On the glass. Great rebound. Great rebound. It's the only way to describe it. He's Yo. Putting in a shift on the glass. Fouls on Bowser. In his first action of the game. Goes underneath. Fouls on the way up. He's gone two fouls already. David Alate is charged with that foul. But so far, it's all about Yo. Stroke. Foul shot. Well, he shoots over 80% on the tournament. 17 points today. Make that 18. Ties the game at 43. Single-handedly, he is really keeping China in this. Over. Gets the high post screen, can't turn the corner. Grab it. Any time there's indecision, you're going to force a turnover. Alate with the travel. Had the open three, turned it down, put it on the floor, but travel. Oh, feeling it from the perimeter. Knocks down the three. Yo, gets a beautiful little run up by Loba. Yeah, giving it some noise, I think that was a Clover, but beautiful run. China lead it by one. They're finding that high post gap now against the zone. Yao for three, count those. Again, it's all about the pass to the inside first, though. Get the ball into the high post. Get the defense collapse. Loba outside the three-point line. Again, the defensive rotation by China is excellent. Under 10 on the shot clock. We've got a foul call on the screen. Can't just mow over the screener, which is what Joe did. Substitution, Spain. Joe picks up foul two, but China still lead it by four. 8-12 to go. He has 18. Battle of the big man at the moment. Yu has 18. Diop has 18. Stop, didn't throw into the high post that time. But gone for the lob. Chance to spray the run. 3-on-1. Should be and is. Marlon missed the gimme. The little two-footer. Wide open layup is blown. Oh, he goes inside to Diop. Diop swarming around him, inside, outside, pass, good for three. Alberto Marquez gets his first three of the game. The benefit of going inside first though, Spain. Back in front. Still staying with his own. China, don't throw it to the high post again. Spinning move, kicks out. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Three's deep in the corner, he's good. Heng knocks it down from deep. China back in front by two. Martin turns the corner, goes to Diop. Too much rotation on the defense. Yeah, great job, great pass, and they throw it, they turn it over. Everyone got carried away. Everybody got carried away. There was a two-point of just screaming out to be made. Go. 2-point lead for China. Martin comes off the off-screen. Diop rolls. They're not going to make the same mistake. Now that's good. High-low pass. Diop goes up. Misses it. Diop gets another block. Don't you love this matchup? And Diop gets sucked into a foul at mid-court by Diop. Diop picks up foul three. Spain move on to the third team foul. Diop just looked for him and Diop just ran into the back of him. That's a play way older than Diop's 16 years. Oh, a 5-3, they're feeling it against his own. Great work. But so they had to stop it because it looked like to me that Feng got a real bang in the face. Yu Fen Heng gone down. Feeling that one. Let's have a look. Oh, slapped in the face unintentionally by Simone Diop. Full court pressure by China now. It's a nice move by Coach Wang. As long as they're smart, it's an excellent move. A little bit of push makes Spain make more decisions. Try and force them to go a little bit quicker. China lead this 52-50, just over 6 minutes to go. Goes outside to 3-point line, goes to Martin, goes to Diop. This is going to get a little predictable. Nice pass though, Abelardi. Puts it on the floor, good defense by China. Abelardi goes inside, gets a little bump, goes full. Off the glass, China come down with a defensive rebound. gets it back. 2-3 zone steal by Stanek. Nice pass to the inside. And we're going to travel forward, and Beaulieu's got to be confident there. A great opportunity to score, travelled on the play. Hughes carrying four fouls into this last 5.5 minutes. Martin coming off the high post screen. Diop post, gets it, showing the double team. Diop tries to back in, now he's going to kick it out. Martin, 5 seconds on the shot clock, fires out the three. Oh! With people hanging all over him, Alberto Martin, 12 points personal, 2-3 from the three-point line. And Spain go back in front by one. Throw it in high, that's the pass, make the defense react to that. Oliu pulls up, it's long, Diop keeps it alive, Martin has it. Martin loving this moment, this is where you see the character of these young players. Diop goes to work, kicks it out, repositions, good defense. In transition we have a foul. Martin fouls smartly, picks up foul one, but that is Spain's fourth team foul. Yao goes in high again. They use the high post, they do, inside, outside, nice play. The three is short, oh, and I think that's his fifth. How important is that going to be? 1 point game. Martin has it and looks like he's loving the situation. Moves it on. No, gets it back to him. Martin. Well, moves it on. Strong move. Martin has it. Steps back. Tough shot is short. Oh, Spain take it off themselves almost. Chance for China to run. Dylan Hahn thinks twice about the three-pointer. And don't think twice about it on the far side. Joel, who has a tougher one, still fired it up. Just over 3.5 to go. Spain. Lead by one. Jordan looks to go to Diop on the inside, he gets the drop. Timeout China, 55-52. Neymar Diop has 20 personal. Spain have a 3-point lead. China take the timeout. Too close to call this one. Yeah. China looks to go inside, turning it over. Great hands by Martin, so quick. Going up for two is good. Sloppy by China, another turnover. Yao takes over the point guard responsibilities. Yao has it. Yao. Yao guarding. Floats it to Yao. Yao trying to get up in traffic. Somehow gets it up. But Spain now leads by. And this will be time in possession. Spend as much time in possession. Marcelo. Keeping the ball now, down to 9 on the shot clock. Diop's going to get it. 5, Diop, faces up. Got to put it up. Offensive foul call. Good stand. Yu again picks up another positive stat. Draws another foul. Still only a 5-point game. Diao puts it on the floor, steps back. Needs a little bit more movement for his teammates. Steps back for 3, doesn't hit anything. That's not the way China are going to win this game. Martin will try and eat out as much of the 24-second clock as he can. Gets it back, now he goes inside to Diao, under 10 on it. Diop trying to spread the floor. Diop going to work. Step back 2 is fouled. 23 seconds of the 24 second shot clock used. Diop picks up foul number 2. 1:47 to go. Excellent series by Spain. Diop is not the best free throw shooter in the world at all. He makes that one. He's only shooting 60% for the tournament so far. 21 points, 10 rebounds, just a normal day at the office for a 16-year-old. Makes the free throw. Takes the blow. China. We'll take the timeout, 1:46 to go. They'll get the ball in the front court. They now trail by 7 and they need a good score as quickly as possible next time out. Well, there are those 2 meters. Yao, as we said, Yao has come up with double-double. He hasn't had a lot of touches the last couple of times down. Diop with his big 22 points. How big are those 11 rebounds by? Oh, yes. Points in the paint, what a number, 34 to 18. Yo's got all those points in the paint for China. One man band in there. China have it, 7-point game. And a foul's going to be called on Aliati. Aliati is charged with the foul. Diop's going to come straight back. And every foul Spain commit is going to send China to the line, so very quick foul. China in a 7-point hole, can't. They've got to stop digging by making their free throws. Cool as you like. Just strokes it. 2 for 2 for Yao. again outside the three-point line, moves it. Goes. Martin, who wants to get it back to him, he does. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Spain showing great maturity. Martin for three is off. Offensive rebound, no. Defensively, Cloudy is close to getting that with 1:18 to go. It's a five-point game. Great maturity by Spain to just time and possession. Could have needed to get a more aggressive shot. Elatis back in, Diop comes out. Yo. And you need a penetration. Yao going to the middle, floats one up. Ooh, doesn't get the drop, but will go to the free throw line with just a minute to go. To try and make it a three-point game. Alberto Martin picks up foul two. Two huge free throws to come here. Yao makes the first. Shooting around 70% for the tournament so far from the free throw line is Yao Yao. He goes 1-for-2. 4-point game. Last minute. China have got to come up with something here. Yao misses the shot to the far side of the ring. Diao going up in traffic, floats it off the glass, doesn't get the drop. Diao pulls a huge rebound and is fouled. Diao wants the foul going on the way up. That's his first full. And Diao will walk down the floor to shoot the free throws. The foul, but Diao will claim he was fouled on the way up. Here's Diop on the free throw line. 4-point game, 35 seconds to go. Diop really does need to make both. Makes the first. Great focus for a youngster. 5-point game, 23 points. Goes 2-for-2. China takes the timeout, 6-point game. It's still only a two-shot game. But do they go quick for a two? One thing is they've got to be aggressive to create the opportunity. Here they come. Diao coming off the screen. Tries to turn the corner. Wide open for three is off. Not sure if it's the best answer. Knocks away. Who's coming up with that? Body's on the floor. Trying to get it. And there's a foul by Diao. Great hustle. 6-point game. Ogres is charged with the foul. Let's have a look. There's the foul. In fact, the foul's on Ilati. But Diao's going to the free throw line. Must make both. Diao. Makes the first. Makes it a four-point game if he makes it. 18.1 with the way Spain have shot free throws in this competition. Could, there's a lifeline here for China. Diao makes both. Timeout. Spain take the timeout. They lead by four. They can almost touch that semi-final. But that's not enough. You've got to get over the finishing line. There's the foul trouble. Diop has four. That's why he's been in and out, playing offense and deep and not defense. No other major issues. Everyone else on two. Now that Liu's fouled out, Diao has three. So if they do get back in this, the guard's really going to have to be controlled. Spain almost in touch. I can definitely smell the semi-final of the Under-17 World Championships here in Lithuania. Must be looking at a steal or a foul here. See how once the smaller came off of the off, but referees won't have it. See if that. The off. Does his free throw technique hang hold strong here? Makes it first. 5-point game. Oh, 100% today. See how he does, or how he can miss. Shoot that one 10 foot half an inch. Just about gets it to drop. 63-57. Trying to need it quick, and they need it quick and good. Yao trying to make something happen. Great back screen. Defensive recovery. The three is off. Defensive rebound. Should do it. And Spain now have 1 foot and one toe, it looks like, in the semi-final. They lead 63-57. What a valiant effort by China. It looks like it's going to come up short. You've got to credit the changes that the Spanish coaching staff made. They trail by 11. Halfway through the third quarter. It's a 17-point turnaround. Make that an 18-point turnaround. 7-point lead here for Spain. 5 seconds to go. 5 seconds between Spain and an appearance in the Under-17 World Championship semi-final. Threes away on the buzzers, no good. And Spain celebrate a trip to the semi-finals of the World Championship. China will have a what could have been moment. They led by 11 and all the momentum. Spain made some changes and outscored them by 18 points in around 15 minutes of basketball. Great effort by China. They should hold their heads high. They'll go into the consolation games for 5th to 8th place. Spain will go on to tomorrow, to the semi-final. Oh, here are the... Well, there were going to be the stats. Here are some replays. But what turned out to be a valiant effort by China, but all in vain. As after they sprinted in the third quarter to 11-point lead, Spain responded to 2-3 zone. And the perimeter game that had been absent up until then returned to Spain, and Alberto Martin and Alberto Boldi in the backcourt began to make jump shots, and freed up space for Diop there on the inside to amass another huge game personally for him. But it's Spain to progress to the semi-finals of the FIBA Under-17 World Championships here in Lithuania. They'll be tomorrow, today and this afternoon. This is for Spain to celebrate. There are the stats. Rebound dominance and turnovers by China probably proved decisive in the end. 18 chips to the free throw line was decisive as well. But it's going to be Spain with a 62-55 victory over China. that make it to the semi-finals of the under 17 FIBA World Championships. In the game, and Diop there with 20 points. You're going to see him all over the leaders as well. Diop had 26 for Spain, Martin with 14, Abordi with 9. Those two in particular really did, alongside Drover there with his 5, just get the lid off that basket in the second half and started to knock down those perimeter shots that gave him the scoring balance to get back in the game. Diop there with 15 rebounds. Diop had 11 to go with his 20 plus points. Mathieu there with a tremendous 20 plus points, 15 rebound game. He just didn't have the support he needed from the rest of that China lineup. Full action. If we look at the game leaders, there's action to come here from Lithuania on FIBA TV. All four quarterfinals, 3 to go still. China have been eliminated by Spain. Canada will face the USA in the next quarterfinal, and we'll be back here in Lithuania for that game between the two North American basketball powers. Can America continue the defense of their world title? Join us again later this afternoon for game 2 of the quarterfinal day. And we will see you for that quarterfinal. We'll leave you some stats and then some replays. It's bye from Lithuania for the moment.